arc length, area of a sector. Really quick, really easy problems. Arc length formula, S equals R theta. Area of a sector formula, A equals 1/2 R squared theta. For both of those formulas to work, theta must be in radians. So if we give it to you in degrees, the way you switch to radians is you multiply by pi over 180 right there. Area of a sector, that's like the slice of the pie, slice of the pizza, that area of that pizza slice, or the slice of the pie right there, right? So I tell you how to switch it from degrees to radians, and then you just plug and chug into the formula. All four of these are identical to each other, so they're pretty much, you know, a couple different numbers there, but let's do one from scratch, all right? So if I give you the radius is 16, the theta is 120, so the first thing you gotta do is take the 120 degrees, we're gonna times it by pi over 180 to switch it to radians, and then 120 over 180 reduces to 2/3. So this would be 2 pi over 3 radians. And we got to get this exact answer right here. And then so if I'm going to do arc length, that's just R times theta. So that radius is 16. And then I'll times it by the 2 pi over 3. And that's 16 over 1. So this will give us 32 pi over 3. So there is our arc length. And it's mentioned inches there. So that's just the length of the, you know, the circular arc there in inches there. And then for the area of a sector, we'll do A equals 1/2 times the R squared theta. And again, the theta has to be in radians, which is why we found the 2 pi over 3. So you can't just plug in the 120 right there. You're going to get it wrong. So you're going to go 1/2 times your R squared times the 2 pi over 3, and then just plug all that stuff into the calculator there. So I know 16 squared is going to be 250. Here, I realize that those twos are going to cancel, and then 16 squared is going to be 256. The pi is still there, and then the 3 is still there. Now, technically, since this is an area, that would be inches squared right there. All right, and then I do have a note on my work there. So I got all four problems there, all my work, all the answers right there. Real easy formulas. Just follow that, switch it to degrees, switch it to radians, use the two formulas, get those easy stuff, right? And then I do have a note that says if they give us the diameter, then you got to remember to divide that by 2 to get the radius. So all those above have the radius. But if I were to tell you that the diameter was 32, then you would cut it in half and use the radius as 16. So I don't know why I have a note for that. There might be a reason for that. So just kind of keep that in mind as you're working out those problems. But those are quick and easy problems. So just know the formulas. And I just want to mention that those formulas are on your formula reference sheet that I gave you there, the area of a sector, area of the arc length.